हेलो अच्छा लोग, सो हाउ इज द लेक्चर? गुड. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द पार्ट टू ऑफ द वेक्टर कैलकुलस. ओके, सो व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू, पर्संस हु आर न्यू ऑन द यूट्यूब चैनल, they should go on the lecture 18 and 19. Okay? So here I will be dealing line integral, surface integral, and volume. So what's new in the lecture? The new thing is we have to summarize the things so that within the one lecture I can understand the whole thing. So bachcha, when I talk about line integral, in case of line integral, whether it is UPSC CSE exam or IFOS exam or any other IDZAM exam type of exams, if you are writing for that. Basically, our lecture series is focused for this. So, when I talk about line integral, in case of line integral, what I need to do is, I have to find integration f vector dot dr vector, where f vector is a vector valued function. Okay, bachche. Along the curve C. What it means actually, suppose that someone asks you to find 2x square I cap plus yz k cap dot dx I cap plus dy j cap along the curve C, where C is a straight line. What bachche? Where C is a straight line passing through two points, let's say P1, X1, X2, X3 and PQ. Q is X2, Y2, X1, Y1, Z1, X2, Y2, Z2. So what they wish to have, they want to calculate this integral along a straight line joining these two points. Okay bachche, so this is denoted as this: integrate C f vector dot dr vector along the curve C. Is that clear? There may be a possibility ki they want to calculate this integral along the parabola y equals x square from the point 0,0 to the point 2,1, let's say. Clear? So what will be my C here? Please focus on the sign, because if you reverse the sign, the integration will come out with negative sign. Okay, so in case of single integration to fark nahi padega, but in case of multiple integrals hoga kya, wo add hoke, that can change the value. So please focus on the sign, means direction. Okay bachche, chalo. So, calculating this integral along the parabola from the point this O to, let's say, Getting? So this itself is a problem of line integral. What happens if, please listen carefully here, what happens if I find the same integral along the straight line joining the point P and Q? Okay, that is the problem one. And suppose that I am over this parabola and this is the point, same x1, y1, z1, and this is the point x2, y2, z2, and I want to calculate along the curve C2. Means, suppose that isko I call it as f vector dot dr vector. So now I am more interested in knowing the integration f vector dot dr vector from the point P to Q along the curve C1, that is my straight line path. Will it be same? I am saying will it be same as integration f vector dot dr vector along the curve C3, where C3 is a path that is parabolic path from the same point P to Q. So from here the concept of line integral becomes more interesting actually. What bache? Getting the line integral f vector dot dr vector between the point P to Q by following different paths. What bache? By following different paths. Let's say this is a straight line path, this is a parabolic path, someone may follow like this. So can we conclude, देखिए लाइन इंटीग्रल विल बिकम वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर यू वंस यू आर एबल टू कनेक्ट दीज डॉट्स. कैन वी कंक्लूड दैट इंटीग्रेशन सी एफ वेक्टर डॉट डी आर वेक्टर विल बी सेम एज अलोंग द कर्व सी वन, अलोंग द कर्व सी टू, अलोंग द कर्व सी वन, व्हेन दिस रिमेन्स सेम इंटीग्रल. सो दैट इज माय क्वेश्चन मार्क देयर. इफ नॉट ऑलवेज, इफ not always, then I am interested in knowing what are those conditions for which this happens. So here the third, number one is calculating the line integral. Number two is line integral calculating from different paths. Number three is calculating the line integral f vector dot dr vector from the point P to Q by following different paths. Then this line integral becomes same, then what is the condition over? So, अपने क्लास का एक टारगेट ये भी है कि what are those conditions under which this quantity becomes same. Either I follow C1, C2, C3 or whatever. I'm not talking about that because वहां पर मैंने पॉइंट चेंज कर दिए. So, for this line integral, as a mentor, my duty is to make you learn these things. Because calculating line integral, that is 5 minutes ka game only. The thing is, and please mark star here. Actually, you know what I learned as a teacher? If you are elaborating, if you are connecting dots, all possible dots for a topic, you will realize ki you can solve every problem from that question, that paper itself, that chapter itself. So what I observed during my 15 years ki these are the peripherals of line integral. If I am clear about these dimensions, then I can handle this chapter, vector calculus, as well as the fluid dynamics ka kinematics wala part. बस समझ में आया? चलिए. So यहाँ पर star mark कहने का मतलब कि यहाँ से you will have once your short question. Calculating line integral directly they are not going to ask. They will ask indirectly. Okay. Integration f vector dot dr vector fd cos theta. The work done. What बच्चे? Work done by the force f vector. For moving a particle for d displacement, what is that? Fd cos theta means f vector dot d vector. So what will be the work done? Another type of question from the line integral. What bache? Work done. So to get the work done, dhyan se sunna abhi, to get the work done from by displacing a particle from P to Q, what I need to do? I need to calculate from P to Q F vector dot dr vector. Ab samajhna. The actual question comes now. What happens if a person follow the straight line path? What happens if a person follow parabolic path or this path, then what will be the change in work done? Getting my point? So another kind of question is ki work done by some force vector F vector, okay, from P to Q, under what conditions work done will not depend on path followed from P to Q. This is another kind of question for us. You getting my point? बात समझ रहे हैं आप लोग? आप लोग नोट्स बनाते रहिए. प्लीज कीप प्रिपेयरिंग योर नोट्स. सच पॉइंट्स आर आउटकम्स ऑफ इयर्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइजेस. So ultimately, what I have now, in case of line integral, लिख दो यहाँ पर, calculating line integral type 1 problem, type 2 problem, conditions for which integration C F vector dot dr vector will be independent of the path chosen. The type 3, this is important for fluid as well. What is that condition over F? Please note it down. Condition over F vector. F vector should be of the del phi ka form. Please notice. If F vector is of the form del phi, इसका मतलब समझ रहे हैं? F vector is of the form del phi means F vector is dever phi over dever x I cap, dever phi over dever y j cap, plus dever phi over dever z k cap. So what happens in case F vector is of this form? So क्या this condition will fulfill my desire for this? लोगों ने पढ़ा होगा उनको मजा आ गया होगा. So this is the theme of this line integral वाला chapter. Clear? So I have written points over that PDF. कि इंटीग्रेशन पी टू क्यू एफ वेक्टर डॉट डी आर वेक्टर इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द पाथ चूज़न इफ एफ वेक्टर इज ऑफ द फॉर्म डेल फाई. इफ एफ वेक्टर इज ऑफ द फॉर्म डेल फाई देन एफ वेक्टर इज कंजर्वेटिव. कंजर्वेटिव क्यों? एफ वेक्टर अगर डेल फाई की फॉर्म में है तो कंजर्वेटिव मींस कर्ल ऑफ एफ वेक्टर इज जीरो. सो कर्ल ऑफ अगर एफ वेक्टर इस फॉर्म में है तो कर्ल ऑफ डेल फाई इज व्हाट? ग्रेड फाई. सो कर्ल ऑफ ग्रेड फाई इज ऑलवेज जीरो. Means if f vector is of this form, then curl of f vector will be always 0. Means if f vector is of this form, then f vector will be always a conservative force field. Clear or not? Linkages हो पा रहे हैं या नहीं हो पा रहे हैं तो वीडियो को फिर से शुरू से देखो. अभी क्या करते हैं? Just I am suggesting you. प्लीज रीड आउट दीज पॉइंट्स. मैंने इनके प्रूफ भी किए हैं पीडीएफ में. सो इफ यू विल रीड दोज प्रूफ्स, एक्चुअली दोज आर क्लास नोट्स ना. सो वट एवर द डाउट्स कैन हैव अमंग दोज 400 स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल दोज डाउट्स आर इनकाउंटर्ड इन दोज क्लास नोट्स. सो इफ यू रीड दोज क्लास नोट्स, एवरीथिंग इज क्रिस्टल क्लियर. इन दिस लेक्चर आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू कन्वे द मैसेज कि लाइन इंटीग्रल को डील कैसे करना होता है, व्हाई वी स्टडी सच कंडीशंस. ओके बच्चे, एनी इशू? फाइन. चलो लेट्स सी सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर दिस. एक्चुअली आई विल गाइड यू हाउ टू डील द लाइन इंटीग्रल के क्वेश्चंस. Whenever some specified form is there, okay. Suppose that, but मैं आपको केवल समझाने के लिए बात करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. मान लो f vector मेरा है, that is x square I cap plus y z cap minus 2 k cap, something like that, okay. And you want to calculate integration c f vector dr vector, where c is a curve joining two points. Let's say आपने कोई दो points ले लिए, and then okay, joining two points. अब मान लो इफ यू फॉलो द स्ट्रेट लाइन पाथ, ओके, और इफ यू फॉलो सम अदर पाथ, स्फेरिकल और लाइक इलिप्टिकल पे, इलिप्सॉइड पे जाएंगे, तो व्हाट आई नीड टू डू इज इन केस ऑफ कैलकुलेटिंग सच इंटीग्रल्स. ऑल्सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दिस थ्रू पी वाई क्यूज, दे आस्क सच क्वेश्चंस. व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज फर्स्ट यू नीड टू फाइंड द स्ट्रेट लाइन का इक्वेशन. व्हाट बच्चे? इक्वेशन ऑफ अ स्ट्रेट लाइन जॉइनिंग टू पॉइंट्स. ओके, सो फॉर दिस 3D में देयर इज अ चैप्टर स्ट्रेट लाइन, चैप्टर 2 ऑफ चैप्टर 3 ऑफ दैट 3D पार्ट. तो वहां पर वी विल बी डीलिंग दिस. फॉर द टाइम बीइंग यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग ओनली. Symmetrical form में the equation of straight line is given by this, okay, where x1 y1 z1, x2 y2 z1. Fine बच्चे? चल, what we do is इसका करते हैं parameterization. What बच्चे? Parameterization. Please mark star here. So if I want to find the straight line between these two points, क्या हो जाएगा? X minus 1 divided by 0 minus 1, Y minus 2 divided by 1 minus 2 minus 1, Z minus 1 divided by 0 minus 1. So what we do is, इस सारे quantities को equal to some parameter t रख लेते हैं, because ultimately I will try to reduce in one this fraction in one parameter. So, यहां से अपने को क्या दिख जाएगा बच्चे? बोलो, x equals minus t plus 1, y equals minus t plus 2, and z equals minus t plus 1. So if I check for x, x is going from 1 to 0. So यहाँ पर अगला काम आपका होगा, the next job will be limits for t. Parameterize कर दिया है x, y, z को, एक parameter t में लेकर आए, okay? So if I take x का value 0, this will become minus 1, so t का value 1, और x का value जब हम 1 put करेंगे, so this will be 0. So t will be going from 0 to 1. Mark start here. So ultimately, what it will be, dear, यहां पर, this will be reduced to t going from 0 to 1, dr vector is what? Dx I cap plus dy j cap plus dz k cap. So f vector dot dr vector करेंगे, तो x square dx, x की जगह क्या करेंगे? Minus t plus 1, इसका square, अगर x ये है, तो dx क्या हो जाएगा? Minus dt, dy is minus dt, dz is minus dt. So this is minus dt plus y is what? Minus t plus 2 into minus dt plus क्या? Minus 2 into minus 2 into minus dt because these are this. Now अब क्या है? T के respect में integrate कर दिया. Just put the values. You will get the f vector dot dr vector. Why I took this example? Because when you are calculating the line integral, you have to work with one variable. What बच्चे? One variable. इसी को अभी देखना, इसी question में, यहीं पे थोड़ा मजा लेते हैं. If I change this c, कि where c is the curve, the parabola y equals to x square. Suppose that इसके लिए मैं 2D में लेकर आता हूँ इसको, for example. अच्छा इसको मैं ऐसे ही लिख देता हूँ. मैं दूसरा 2D में ले रहा हूँ. F vector equals x square I cap plus y j cap, let's say. And I want to calculate this line integral f vector dot dr vector from 0,0 to suppose that 4, y is x square. So if x ka value 4, to y ka value 16. 4,16. Suppose that I, where c is my curve joining this point O, P to Q. So now what I will be doing is, either I will work with the variable x or with the variable y, because it will be looking like, please be on the board, if I work on x, so x is going from 0 to 4. X square dx plus by, this is by is what? Over this curve C. Check it out. Y is x square. So dy will be 2x dx. Bas, iska calculation kar do. Ho gaya kaam. Clear? So line integral palle pada ya nahi? Koi doubt yahan par? This is one kind of simple questions. Also, I have given the examples in the PDF. Another kind of questions are interesting. So, for that, I need to guide you a bit. Suppose that they have asked you to work done. मान लो f vector is given to you, okay? F1 I cap plus F2 J cap plus F3. This is very like you can say model question for you. If numerical questions are there in the PDF, you can try. So suppose that they ask work done from P to Q. So then we need to find what, bache? P to Q F vector dot dr vector. Please mind it here, please. Now suppose that if f vector is of the form del phi. Let's say f vector is of the form del phi. Or you can say if it is given that f vector is conservative. So this will imply f vector is of the form del phi. Fine. So if f vector is of the form del phi, then इसका मतलब क्या होता है? The integration f vector dot dr vector will be independent of the path chosen from P to Q. Clear है यानी? यहां पर स्टॉप मार कर लेंगे. So let's say they didn't ask कि you have to calculate the straight line path from P to Q. They didn't tell anything, but they knowingly gave you f vector in this form. मतलब they indicated you कि you are free to choose the path. So exam point for you is कि you just take a straight line path, क्योंकि straight line से आसान there will be nothing. So although they didn't ask कि what is the path C is, but if f vector is of this form, then you should choose that P or Q is given to you. So just choose a straight line, अभी just previous वाला example, and calculate this line integral. You will get the work done. Clear or not? Other point. F vector is of this form, independent of the path chosen, a straight line path. Now, work done. देखना बच्चे. Suppose that if I calculate this line integral, please focus. ये वाला और important है, because fluid dynamics में, when you will be working with fluid, there you will be using multiple times this concept. Suppose that f vector is of the form del phi. This implies f1 xyz ai plus f2 xyz j cap plus f3 xyz k cap is I cap dever phi over dever cap dever phi over dever x plus k cap dever phi over dever z. So f1 xyz किस फॉर्म का है बच्चे? Dever. Please notice here, streamline equation, continuity, this equation of continuity, finding that scalar potential. Please notice, otherwise dynamics वाले में हवा हो गया आपका. Scalar potential पूछा जाता है वहां से, तो वहां पर Q vector हम लेते हैं. So, for possible fluid motion, हो क्या जाता है? Curl of Q becomes zero, it means curl of Q सब जीरो होता है. Streamlines के केस में भी हम ये चीज देखते हैं. तो Q vector is of the form del phi. When Q vector is of the form del phi, so here we are dealing that F vector only. In that fluid part, they ask to find scalar potential, mean find phi of x, y, z. Clear? So F1 will be of this form. F2 will be of, and F3 will be, okay bache? Now if you observe it carefully, if you observe it carefully, del phi कहने का मतलब क्या है? If I say F vector dot dr vector, अब यहाँ पर बोल दे, so करो इसको dr vector dot dr vector, तो यहाँ पर dx आ जाएगा, यहाँ dy आ जाएगा, यहाँ dz आ जाएगा. इसका मतलब क्या होगा? This f vector dot dr vector will be reduced of the form dever phi over dever x into dx, dever phi over dever y into dy, dever phi over dever z into dz. This is what बच्चे? D of phi. Exact differential equation. What बच्चे? That is the beauty of the doing rigorous exercise, loving the mathematics. आप बोल रहे हैं ना, message में किसी ने किया था सर, I start loving mathematics for this lecture series. So the reason is this, I don't teach tough things. I teach those things which are simpler but made tough for somehow. I don't know the reason behind that. So f vector if is of this form can be written as f vector dot dr vector. This means there exists a function phi. What bache? There exists a function phi x y z equals c such that d phi is this. D phi means f vector dot dr vector is this. So d phi. अब यहां से आते हैं, हम यहां वापस वर्तन वाले पे. So d phi बोलता है कि this integral does not depend on the path. So phi is the scalar potential in the fluid dynamics. यहां पर phi is the work done for us. So phi x y z is our work done. So either you calculate this f vector dot dr vector or by comparison of this. What बच्चे? By comparison of this get phi of x y z equals c. Please mark star here. Please mark star here. These are the things which are which should be taught inside the class. So if you have phi of x y z means you have work done. Now you can find the work done at the point p x y z ko p jo point aapko de rakha hai uska values jo bhi hoga 1.2 1.2.1 whatever is given. Similarly, so this is an example explained in your PDF. I mentored you here. Whatever the possibilities could be, I conveyed differential equation, fluid dynamics, simple integral, vector integral, everything. What I suggest you when you by comparing all these things now, then you will need total differentiation, total differential equations or Pfaffian differential equations. Okay? To solve such problems or to get y. So yahan par I will mark star Pfaffian differential equation MDR Singhania ke andar aapko diya hua hai. If you are interested enough, you can go through that. For this particular chapter, those are not required that much. What you require is practicing. Just writing. For example, somewhere you have been written x square dx plus y square dy equals to 0. So obviously it is not like x dx plus y dy likha hai. So this is nothing but d of x square divided by 2 equals to c. Now you can integrate, you can find x square plus y square by 2 equals to c, means x square y square is equal to r square, some circle kind of family of circles. So thing is, what I wanted to convey here, ki either you learn these Pfaffian differential equations or by practicing these, try to get that phi of x, y, z. If you are able to get this phi by simply these management of terms, not if, actually you are required to do that. So you have to solve all those examples given in the PDF. Okay dear, I guess mentoring part is enough for the line integral. Should I move now? Chal. Okay. Another important or like very interesting concept I have for you guys, special for you. Sometimes I do think, yeah, camera ke samne kya bol raha hai. But okay, that's the life of a teacher, the new era. Vector calculus. लाइन इंटीग्रल हो गया, अब हम आते हैं सरफेस इंटीग्रल पर. व्हाट बच्चे? सरफेस इंटीग्रल. way to do this topic is first understand the ABCD. Then you are required to solve problems. And there are very standard problems: paraboloid, cylindrical surface, spherical surface, like this only, cone, hai na? So my like way of working is, first you have to learn that ABCD, then those fixed kind of surfaces, practice for all those surfaces. Ki if I take the cylinder, so what are those three surfaces, what are those one, like can be one surface, in what conditions, spherical mein, closed and boundedness, how to check and all. The thing is, first you have to understand what is surface integral all about. Uske baad life is easy for you. Chalo. Okay. So integral kya hota hai bachche? Pehle to aap mujhe ye bolo. If you want to integrate something, means differentiation. Integration is just reverse process of differentiation. So dividing this into pieces of infinitesimally small, then adding those infinitesimally small pieces. So first is differentiation, other is integration. So that is the line integral. If it becomes a surface, so surface ke case mein, suppose that this is a surface, so what you will be doing is infinitesimal blocks, chote chote blocks hain, you will add those infinitesimally small blocks, you will get the whole surface area. Clear? बस इतना ही है मतलब है. So if I am talking about this surface, so what I'll be doing is कि I will be dividing this surface into some infinitesimally small surfaces. Okay बच्चे? Let's say this is an elementary surface ds, small, infinitesimally small. For the vector calculus, here I will have some notations. So surface integral क्या होगा? इन छोटे-छोटे parts को add करने के बाद, whatever you got the, so surface integral for suppose that f vector dot ds vector over the surface S. Let's say this is the surface S. So f vector ds vector. Here you will encounter a word flux. Not only in vector calculus, also in the fluid dynamics and Euler's equation wala chapter especially. Okay, so whenever you are talking about flux, magnetic, so whenever someone talking about flux in mathematics, we will not go into the physics, we will just take it as ki bhaiya surface integral chahiye, seedha bolo. Flux means we need to calculate the surface integral f vector dot ds vector. Fine. Similarly, greatest rate of increase decrease वाले में क्या बोला था? Whatever you say, directional derivative, normal, tangent plane, greatest rate of increase decrease. Ultimately, you are asking me to find grade f. That's it. So here, flux, if you are talking, means the surface integral f vector dot ds vector. So what is that ABCD that we need to understand here is, suppose that I am writing ds vector as, please be on the board, ds cos alpha. Abhi I am coming over here, why I am writing like this, ds cos beta j cap plus ds cos gamma k cap. Visible or not? Dikh raha hai udhar tak? Ds cos alpha I cap plus ds cos beta j cap plus ds cos gamma k cap. Just to make you visualize, what I am doing is, suppose that I am over the XYZ plane, 3D plane, and suppose that this is my some straight line OP, and let's say this makes the angle beta with this, this makes the angle alpha with this, and this makes the angle with gamma with Z axis. So for this straight line, in the 3D part we actually study. So yahan par what, like, you should not feel the big concept, that is why I am putting bit intro here, and the rest of the things we can discuss in the 3D part. So if I want to write x y z, and suppose that this modulus of this is r,
So I can write x upon r as cos alpha, y upon r as cos beta, and z upon r as cos gamma for this straight line, the triangular part is given. So ultimately you can write it as x r cos alpha, y r cos beta, z r cos gamma. So if I write vector r vector, so what it will be xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap. So it can be written as r cos alpha I cap plus r cos beta j cap plus r cos gamma k cap. Okay, this is for the line position vector. R vector can be written like this. Similarly, I can think of the surface vector, ds vector. So what is that? Suppose that this is the surface and this makes an angle alpha. This is the surface. This makes an angle alpha with the x-axis. So if you have some surface, suppose that this, and this makes the angle alpha with x-axis as alpha, suppose that y ke saath this make as beta, suppose that z ke saath mein this make as gamma. So in case of, in the same pattern if we follow, ds is the elementary surface area, this can be written as, getting, so direction cosines and all we will deal later. For here ds vector is represented like this. Koi issue? Chala. So for any vector, a vector, can I write it like, check it out, इसको थोड़ा सा उल्टा लिख दें, अगर हम a vector can be written as a cap modulus of a vector. Similarly ds vector can be written as n cap dot modulus of ds vector. Let's say I represent ds vector ka modulus by simply ds. Please focus here, n cap will come into the picture now. So here n cap, here n cap is a unit vector normal to the surface S. Please mark star here. N cap is what? Unit normal vector to the surface S. और जैसे ही दोस्त आपने बोला normal, ज्ञान चक्षु खुले, normal to some surface, what? दोस्त आओ, grade S. So if you want normal at some particular point, what we need to do is, we will find grad S at that point P and will divide this by modulus of grad S at that point P, because grad will represent a normal vector to that surface S at the point P, and divided by modulus means that is unit normal vector. So in case of surface integral, that will be your step 1. What bache? जो भी सरफेस, वट एवर सरफेस इज गिवन टू यू, यू नीड टू फाइंड ए यूनिट नॉर्मल वेक्टर टू दैट सरफेस. यूनिट नॉर्मल वेक्टर टू दैट सरफेस इज नथिंग बट यू हैव टू फाइंड ग्रेड ऑफ दैट सरफेस, दैट सरफेस एंड डिवाइडेड बाय मॉडुलस ऑफ ग्रेड. क्लियर है? ये चीज क्लियर है? ये हम क्यों कर रहे हैं? बिकॉज डी एस वैक्टर विल बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई एन कैप डी एस. Any issues there? Any doubt? Now I come here. So if I replace, what I am doing is, if I replace ds vector by n cap ds, this will be ds cos alpha I cap plus ds cos beta j cap plus ds cos gamma k cap. अच्छा दोस्त, what happens if I take the dot product with I cap on both sides? So what it will happen? ds cos alpha I dot I 1, I dot j 0, k dot k 0. So what I have, बच्चे, please please do remember this expression. Means ds cos alpha is nothing but I cap dot n cap ds. Koi issue? Now, geometrically, what is this ds cos alpha? What is this ds cos alpha? This is nothing but orthogonal projection. Orthogonal projection of ds on yz plane. Please remember here, when you talk about ds cos alpha, like yahan par x kya tha? This wala part. This is what? Orthogonal projection of this OP on the y-axis. Similarly here, similarly there. So ds cos alpha is nothing but orthogonal projection of that ds wala part on the yz plane. Parchai, projection, parchai. What you said, na? I am telling you. Suppose that this is the solar plate and this is like this. Now look, projection of this over the surface of earth. Kaisa dikhai dega? Bas wahi hai ye. So if suppose that this is a rectangle shape, please focus. If this is a small jo element aapne liya rectangle hai, तो इसका जो मैं प्रोजेक्शन ले रहा हूं बाई जेड प्लेन पर, दैट विल बी अ रेक्टेंगल विद दिस और नॉट, एनी इश्यू? सो दिस डीएस कॉस अल्फा वाला पार्ट कैन बी रिप्लेस्ड बाई डी वाई इंटू डी जेड. अब बोलो. सो इफ आई कंसोलिडेट सिमिलरली ds cos beta, that is dx dz, ds cos gamma dz dy, no sorry dx dy. Do you remind karo, fir se dekh lo parchhai rectangular shape. So now what I will be doing is to calculate the surface integral f vector dot ds vector. I will be changing this into surface integral f vector dot n cap ds. Okay, bachche. And later on, first step is n cap to find karna hi hai. N cap you have find. And ds will be represented by f vector dot dn. Suppose that dy over dz. So if I am doing dy over dz, means I am multiplying by I cap. So this will be I cap dot n cap ka modulus. Is that clear or not? Any issue? Please focus here. Please do remember, otherwise you will land up with wrong results. I'm pretty sure. So why calculating? Suppose that you know y or z ka limit. So what you do? इसका आपने ऑर्थोगोनल प्रोजेक्शन ले लिया बाई जेड प्लेन पर. सपोज दैट एक्स वाई प्लेन पर यू कैन टेक द प्रोजेक्शन, तो यहां पर हो जाएगा डी एक्स डी वाई. इफ डी एक्स डी वाई इज हियर, सो हियर यू विल बी हैविंग जे कैप डॉट एन कैप. क्लियर हुआ? सो दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ कंसेप्चुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग. अब इसके बाद क्या है, मल्टीपल इंटीग्रल का खेल बचा हुआ है. So whenever someone asks to find your flux, ultimately he is asking you to find surface integral f vector dot ds vector. So first stage is find n cap, then just this find multiple integral, double integral aapke paas yahan par hoga. I am again and again suggesting, please do focus here, orthogonal projection. Clear? Why I am saying it? Because multiple times, suppose that you have the cylindrical surface, please be on the board. Suppose that in the xy plane, this is z equals to, suppose that 0, and this is z equals to 5, and this is obviously x square plus y square is equal to some circle. It is cylindrical, and a circle banenge. So let's say this is 4. And they want you to calculate What happens, bachche?
They want you to calculate surface integral f vector dot ds vector, where f vector.
Please focus on the board. I'm telling you how to calculate the surface integral.
And f vector is given to you, let's say.
Okay.
So first step is finding n cap. Kaise? Grade S divided by modulus of grade S.
Once you know the n cap, now your duty is to find surface integral. Suppose that this is the surface. XY plane mein z equals to 0. Tell me.
So calculating this n cap. Suppose that I talk this as S1 surface, this as S2 and this as S3. So for the surface S1,
n cap kya hoga?
By z plane, ye dhakkan niche ki or jayega. So n cap will be minus the k cap.
By z, xy plane ke perpendicular, z plane. So by z, xy plane par, what is n cap? Either plus ka k cap or minus ka k cap, upward or downward.
So for this surface, n cap kya ho jayega bachche?
Minus k cap.
For this surface, n cap kya ho jayega?
Plus ka k cap. Clear?
And for this S2 is what? This. So for this you need to find grade S. This is your S2. So grade S2 divided by grade S2.
Grade means gradient.
So del of S iska nikalna hoga kya ho jayega? 2xi cap plus 2y j cap divided by 4x square plus 4y square. So 4x square plus 4y square 16 divided by 4. So this is nothing but x by 2y cap plus y by 2 j cap.
Ho gaya, n cap mil gaya. Clear?
So step 1 is finding n cap. So this surface integral is for surface 1, for surface 2, plus for surface 3. So for surface S1, iske liye jab calculate karna hoga, to f vector dot n cap find kar lijiye. Same for f vector dot n cap iske liye, f vector dot n cap iske liye.
Clear? Wait a bit. What will happen?
On calculating this fraction, now you will just put here. Kya karenge? Surface integral f vector dot n cap.
And this is the final step to calculate the surface integral.
What is that? F vector dot n cap you have.
Now,
for this surface, z is 0 means x square plus y square equals to isko main hata do beech se. अब देखिएगा, for this S1, क्या है surface?
Circle है ना, xy plane पर.
So x square plus y square is 4. तो either you write x equals to r cos theta, y equals to r sin theta. R will go from minus 2 to 2, or theta will go from 0 to 2 pi. Either you write like this. तो इस case में suppose that S1 वाला जो part है, f vector dot n cap मान लो आपके पास कुछ phi निकला and ds को you just taken projection over the xy plane. So if dx into dy is here, then don't forget यहाँ पर क्या होगा k cap dot n cap का modulus. Don't forget the modulus. So इसके लिए n cap क्या था? Minus k cap. So k cap dot k cap minus 1 आ जाएगा, minus k cap है और modulus लेंगे तो 1 आ जाएगा. Ultimately, it will not alter the result. But if you forget this, then this will be like
aapka baza baza dega S2 mein. Kyunki here it will make impact. Is that clear or not?
So abhi to double integral hai, isko solve kar dena. For S2, f vector dot n cap, suppose that 5-1 aapne nikala. Ab S2, please check it out.
यहां पर गलती होती है. सो मार्क स्टार हियर, यू कैन कमिट मिस्टेक हियर ओनली फॉर दिस सरफेस वाई टू जेड. जब आप इसमें से कोई एक प्रोजेक्शन, कोई एक स्मॉल एलिमेंट उठाएंगे तो उसका प्रोजेक्शन इट विल बी ईदर ऑन वाई जेड प्लेन और ऑन द जेड एक्स प्लेन. ये प्रोजेक्शन एक्स वाई प्लेन पर विल नॉट गो बिकॉज जेड इज बीइंग चेंज फ्रॉम जीरो टू फाइव. क्लियर? सो व्हेन यू विल कैलकुलेटिंग दिस इंटीग्रल यू नीड टू हैव कि एक बार z अल्टीमेटली अगर मन लाइक मजदूरी मेथड में याद करें तो z का लिमिट तो रखना ही है, अदर वाला या तो x का रख लो या y का रख लो एंड कैलकुलेट दिस डबल इंटीग्रेशन. क्लियर है? एंड फॉर s3 इज अगेन सिंपल, f डॉट n कैप वो हमने निकाला हुआ है, लेट्स से दिस इज phi 2 और इसको अगेन dx dy पर. यहां पर डोंट फॉरगेट टू टेक z बराबर z इक्वल्स 5 and here don't miss to take z equals to 0. These are some crucial, very important observations from my set of understanding. If you are able to do, if you are able to visualize at this level, you will be able to solve any surface integral. I have detailed in the PDF. Okay, all examples well detailed. So I am much bothered about making you ki kahan par aap fas sakte hain, where you can get the result as wrong. To maine wahan par likh bhi diya hai aapke liye. Okay. Other part, that is just bachcha wala. What is integrations? Integrations. Many of you will fail in the exam hall to integrate correctly or in a little time because you are not in practice. So practice. Simple integrations ke bhi practice karne hai. Whenever you are calculating these, please reach till the last answer. What bache? Please reach till the last answer. That's it. Is that clear? Any issue in the surface integral? I don't guess so. Chal, cylinder wala surface bhi aapke liye le hi liya. Similarly, you can talk about spherical, paraboloid or whatever is that. Theek hai? So the last topic is volume integral. So here I will suggest you, bas ye double se triple integral pe pahunchega aur dv will be replaced by dx dy dz. And the same pattern what I discussed for surface, small ds liya na, yahan par dv le lenge and infinitesimally small element dv and I'll add that up to the infinite. It will becomes into the volume integral or triple integral. Clear? The basis will be same. Is type ka projection wala khel bhi yahan par nahi hota hai, see the limits you can apply. And how to observe, how to apply those limits for triple integration that already discussed in the part of multiple integral wala chapter. So this is the whole story for line integral, surface integral and volume integral. Now it's your turn to understand these phenomena, to note down each point by point and solve multiple examples multiple times. Like a BSc student. Fine? So, abhi aap kal ka kaam aapka tomorrow's job is this only. Please solve at least 10 questions for each segment, line, surface, volume. Later on, those three important theorems you will realize, yaar kya hai isme? Yahi to hai. Gauss divergence bola, to surface find karo, volume find karo, dono ko equate dikhao. Stokes bol raha hai, line karo, surface karo, equal dikhao. Getting my point? So the theme is, the next lecture is going to be very short, not an issue. If you are practiced enough all these segments, then those theorems are just cup of tea. Unke liye I can leave the message for that third lecture. Fine. So please practice. Keep motivating me. Keep spreading love. Achha bura jaisa bhi hai, do let me in the comment box. And टेलीग्राम चैनल पे डाउट भेजते रहिए, आई विल डीलिंग डाउट्स, कीप फॉलोइंग द डक।